So you were saying?
When it comes to branding systems, your sales and marketing executives are also important. How do you get your salespeople to convince your potential clients that you are the best option in terms of advertising? So I told my salespeople, instead of going out there and just saying, oh, Jessica will deliver LPMs wonderfully, Bernard Avler will add the flavor and the band you need for your LPM, why don't you get them to record? Or we record all our shows, pick a recording, you know, of a few LPMs from whatever has been recorded, put it on a CD and play it for your clients. You see, they said, oh, well, what if, you know, they still, I said, well, you know what, this is what happens. At that point in time, your competitor is not there. So if they hear something and it sounds good enough, it will resonate with them and they won't even think about contacting the competitor. So these are some of the things that you do. I mean, my job cuts across all the different departments. You know, if it's events, fine, we've been doing this event, but how do we do it differently this year so that it will penetrate and stick with the patronizers of the event, the patrons of the event? So many different things. Brand assistance is broad. I could go on and on and on about it.
Wow. Interesting. How did you... I'm trying to understand the story between, because the last time I checked, you were doing a number of things. Mm-hmm. Why Citi FM? How did you end up in Citi FM?
So, I was actually looking for a part-time job because there are a number of businesses that I was flirting with, for example, cooking, interior design. And when you don't have something that's backing you financially, it becomes difficult. So I said, well, I need a part-time job so that whatever I'm doing can in some way feed the other stuff that I'm doing. So a friend of mine I have loads of friends in the media, and they've been trying to get me to media for a while. Oh, you have a nice face, you have a nice voice. And I said, well, what am I going to talk about? I'm not your head-on entertainment person. If you put some certain people in front of me, I'll probably not smile. I won't mention names. But, my philosophies as far as arts and music and whatnot are concerned are generally not manifested in what we see on our Ghanaian entertainment scene. So what am I going to do? Do I love politics and economics and current affairs? Yes. Is this something I want to talk about every day of my life? No. So what am I going to do in media? So a friend of mine says, you know what? She works at Citi FM as well. She says, you know what? Why don't you come spend some time with me at work, see what I do. I'm a producer, you know, I do other stuff. I write for the Weekend Globe. You know, just come see what you think and you might be surprised. So it was around Christmas, so a lot of people were on leave. I went in with her a couple of times and I started feeling at home. Now on one of these visits I met the MD. We had a long conversation, you know, about general things. It had nothing to do with media, really. Just general things, anything from education to politics and in between. And I believe I left an impression on him. So subsequently, my friend says, okay, is Citi somewhere you want to be? I said, let me think about it. So one morning I woke up, I said, well, I got the MD's number. Let me talk to him, see what's available. So I sent him a text message. He immediately replied. He had remembered me. He says, oh, come for a meeting at your convenience. I did that. We had a conversation. I told him, well, this is what I want to do, etc., etc. I was carrying my CV and my application letter even. And I asked him, are there any available positions? He said, well, none that suit your qualifications or your abilities. And I was like, wait a minute, this guy, what's he saying about me?
Wow.
And he says, well, let's have a chat. What interests you? And I told him, I love to write, I love to cook. I love to educate people in any way that I can. I like to talk about controversial social issues that people are usually afraid to tackle. And he says, okay, I have this whole thing with brand insistence in mind. Read about it. Mm. It's a pretty new concept. And tell me what you think. But I'm going to put you somewhere in the production department. And then you can, you know, take it from there. I said, okay, fine. And he says, well, but why didn't you tell me you're looking for a job? And, you know, my friend who worked at Akusia, she said, no, Akusia didn't tell me either. And I said, well, I wasn't sure and I didn't want to say, well, I'm coming and then I disappoint. Something I needed to think about. He says, okay. So for a week, you know, I had meeting on meeting with him, and eventually I started working at Citi. I even started training before I actually started working there, because there were a few workshops with sales and marketing events. So I went to the workshops. And
interesting.
That's how it started, really.
You know, you keep talking about your friend producing a show, you producing a show. What does it really mean to produce a show?
So my boss, Jessica, Jessica doubles as the programs manager. She always tells me that presenters are dumb. So your presenter is like your machine, your producer is the one that feeds it with the information. That's how Jessica described it.
Interesting.
And she told
me,
you know, I got thrown into production. One day MD says, you know what, I'm moving Jessica to the drive, you're going to produce her. We're starting from scratch. Everything that has been done on the drive previously doesn't count anymore. Structure something else. And I said, well, he said, no, you can do it. And so I went to Jessica, of course, not just because I was going to be producing her, not just because she's a programs manager, but because she's an extremely intelligent person and extremely creative as well. And she's a great mentor. She's great at teaching people, you know, and giving you a chance. So I said, well, this is it. We sat down, we structured the show. Then she tells me, she says, you know what? 70% of the success of this show is dependent on you.
Wow.
I'm just the 30. And I didn't understand what she meant
pressure.
Until I actually started doing it. So you need someone to come speak on your show to a particular issue. A lot of people are skeptical about going on air. There are others who are interested about talking on air, but they're not very eloquent. They're not extremely good at imparting their knowledge. So if you take a field like psychiatry, for example, or psychology, there are a lot of people out there who may have studied psychology, but not a lot of them have been practicing it actively. Now, within the people who are practicing it actively, not everybody is eloquent enough to get the issue across to your listenership. So that poses a challenge. But the fact of the matter is, there's a topic I want to talk about, maybe rape, and I need a psychologist, so I need someone to come in. So not only are you finding the person, but now you have to brief the person. This is what I want to do. I want you to tackle the issue from this angle. So I have to prepare questions. I have to guess what Jessica would ask in order to bring out an answer that would be educative enough for whoever is listening to us on air. I also have to guess what questions would be exciting enough that your listeners would want to engage you on social media and whatnot.
And anticipate what kind of questions the listeners could possibly ask themselves.
Precisely, and it's a huge job because you're getting into people's minds now. But apart from that, it's also a lot of writing and scripting. Whatever you hear on air, at least with a station as structured as Citi FM, is pretty much scripted before it goes on air. So yes, your presenter, in my case Jessica, will fill in here and there, but the skeletal script, I've done it for her beforehand. If there's any information, maybe a riddle, so that you can win X or B on the show, I need to go and search for those riddles. Now imagine, on my show, I have to give out 2 tickets to Silverbird every single day, Monday to Friday.
Wow.
That means 5 riddles in a week.
2 tickets, isn't that 10?